Hello everyone, my name is Miguel Capella and I work in Anacom. In the last years, I've been working in spectrum planning and engineering. Today, I will speak about the LSA concept. For that, I will share now a presentation with you. So, before I start speaking about the LSA concept, I will start by trying to explain a little bit what is the radio spectrum. So, the radio spectrum is the set of electromagnetic waves with frequencies between 8.3 kHz and 275 GHz. This is spectrum today allocated by ITU, and that is attributed to different radio communication services like fixed, mobile, broadcasting, and radio location, etc., and some others. Then, the spectrum is used by different services, for instance, GSM, MTS, TETRA, etc. If we increase the frequency, we will have less coverage. And the opposite, if we decrease the frequency, we will have more coverage. I think this took us to a kind of more interesting spectrum for different applications where there is a lot of demand. Lots of users wants to use, let's say, this red spectrum here in this figure. And that is why the spectrum sometimes is not enough for all the requests we can have. So the question is, how can we have more spectrum sharing in these, let's say, more interesting frequency bands? When we have this kind of exclusive spectrum, we need a kind of individual authorization when we can grant a radio license, where these uses are protected against interference. Of course, for this, they have costs, they have to pay. But they have the spectrum for their own, and it is exclusive. Of course, we also have some spectrum sharing today with the general authorization, what we call the short-range devices. But they operate in a non-protection, non-interference basis. They don't have costs, but they can suffer interference. We have some examples here, like Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. For me, the main difference is that when we have an individual authorization, we can plan the network and have a guaranteed quality of service. We say QoS. We can have QoS. On the other side, if we have a general authorization, we do not have QoS guaranteed. I put LSA concept here in the middle. So LSA means license shared access. I'm not saying that is in the middle between individual authorization and general authorization. I'm just saying that this is a new concept that I will explain in the next slide. The RSPG defined the LSA some time ago, and LSA is a regulatory approach where the idea is to introduce new users in a specific frequency band, giving to these new users a kind of license. Of course, if we are having new users, it means that the band is already being used by the incumbent. So the idea is for a specific frequency band where we have incumbent users, we will allow other users there, giving them also quality of service. So both should have quality of service guaranteed. For that, we need to define what will be the sharing rules. In the example here below, we have a scenario where we have unlinked government that is using a few stations. Let me imagine that this is Portugal. They have just some stations here installed. What means that you have lots of space where the spectrum is not used. So the idea is to define where these new users can use the spectrum. What are the conditions for them be allowed to use the spectrum? And also give chances to the incumbent to expand their network if they like. This is not, the LSA concept does not mean that the incumbent cannot develop the network anymore. He can develop the network, the other users can use the spectrum also, and they both coexist here. But let's say that this example is a kind of static scenario. In this LXA implementation, the stations are fixed. The functional blocks of the LXA can be briefly illustrated here. And what we have to do? We will have to have an LXA repository where we define the rules for the sharing of the spectrum. The incumbent know the rules, also the administration, and also the LSA user. And the access to the spectrum of the LSA user is controlled by what we call the LSA controller. So is with these rules and with this repository and controller that spectrum can be used by the license. But the question could be, what are the rules? They have to be defined, and there's a need to have we have an agreement between the incumbent, between the LSA license, and between the administration. Only with that it will be possible to implement this in the field. If the rules are not agreed, no chance to implement the LSA. The pilot, the LSA pilot that we implement in Portugal was in the frequency band 2.3 to 2.4 GHz. This band was, the technical conditions, let's say, for this band were harmonized by the SEC decision 1402, where they defined blocks of 5 MHz with a TDD channelization. So from 2.3 to 2.4 GHz, we have 5 MHz blocks here. And this is the implementation that can be used by mobile networks. We did not implement this decision in Portugal, so we do not have for the moment, and we do not know the future, if there is interest or not, mobile communications in this band. What we have in Portugal today is PMSC users in the frequency band 2.3 to 2.4. You can be here more or less the arrangement. We have four different licenses. And this license gives the user the possibility to use the spectrum anytime and in any place within the national territory. This means that we do not know where or when they are using the spectrum. And this is a difficulty for the implementation of LSA in Portugal, because if you do not know where they are using the spectrum or when, it's very difficult to implement the LSA and sharing of the spectrum. By the way, just a few notes. At this stage, at this moment, SCCPT1 is reviewing the conditions of decision 1402 to include 5G. The LSA has been studied in Europe also, conditions for the use of the spectrum with LSA. What services should we protect? How can we share the spectrum? And we can see that this is not harmonized. The use of the frequency band 2.3 to 2.4 is not harmonized in Europe. Some countries have telemetry, some countries have governmental use, some countries have PMSC, but I suppose with local or specific licenses. So the administration gives the license and knows where the applications, the video links are being used, and we can also have a mature service. I have here just an example of the Italy LSA project, just to say that they have a project too, like us, and this example, they were protecting the fixed service. But they were able to do calculations and to know where they can allow mobile or not in which areas, because they know where the services are operating. What is not our case, like I told you previously, we do not know in Portugal where they are operating, neither when they are operating. So main conclusion from here is that the LSA will have to be adapted to the reality of each country, because each country have different kind of utilizations. That's the main conclusion. My colleague will now explain what was our LSA pilot in Portugal and that, what have we done to try to solve and to try to permit the sharing of the spectrum with conditions that we have today in Portugal. Thank you very much.